Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's a beautiful day. It's a wonderful day. The Bible says this is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Welcome to Not a Novice. This is a very, very, very special edition. Once a month, the last Sunday of the month, we're coming your way with one full hour of teaching, preaching, and praying for healing. This morning, I'm going to preach, I'm going to teach about healing. And I'm believing God that wherever you are, whatever disease, whatever sickness, God is going to touch you. How many believe that God is going to touch you this morning? He is. He is going to touch you. Hallelujah. So I want us to pray wherever you are. You know, wherever you are. Wherever you are. I want you to understand that God's presence is with you, is with us. I want us to pray and ask God to manifest himself in your life today. Wherever you are, maybe this morning you're not well. You woke up with a pain, you woke up with a sickness, or you've been sick for a long time. You've been going to Woodlands, you've been going to all the nice hospitals around, but you know you have not been bettered. This morning, God has an appointment and engagement with you. And so wherever you are, I want us to lift up your voice and just begin to speak in tongues wherever you are. Karandaba sotoromo kebrendes, makatabarande meke bendere mekaria. Mama mandara masataya bakandere meneme. Speak in tongues wherever you are. If you can speak in tongues. We bless in the name of the Lord. Karandere meke brindis. Makatabara makabra bababa. Reke berebe satamandere meke brindere mekeri berebebe. Mama mandere mekabra satabara bakabra baba. Marandara malama mandere me. Katara baraba baba. Mandere meke brindere meke basatara makabra baba derere. Rakata baraba kabra baba babanda sataya malandos rike bere meshete bere meke brende re meka baraba rakata tarabara baba baraba bande reke mola sata baya barabara barabara baba arababa suturu moke brende re meke bere arababa marabande re meka baraba baba barande re mesende re meka baraba. Oh yes, Lord, karabara baba ramama manduru mosite meke brende meke. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. Hallelujah. Psalm 121. Psalm 121. The Bible says, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills. From whence cometh my help? My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. I want us to pray this morning. I want us to pray and ask God for help. For help in your situation. For help in your circumstances. I believe very, very strongly that this one hour, the last Sunday of the month, is a time that God is going to use. You see, when Jesus went to the wedding in Cana of Galilee, the Bible says that he asked them, when the wine was out, there was no wine. So he asked the people to pour water into the vessels. Now, God always uses something to do something. God always uses a medium. God always uses something in somebody. So the water in the containers, the water in the vessels, Jesus needed it. You see, well, you ask yourself, why didn't Jesus just say, you know what, just go into the vessels, you find wine. He asked them to pour water. Because it is the water was the agent he used. This last Sunday of the month, last Sunday of May, you know, the Lord spoke to me when in the last week in April that May was a blessed month for our church, and God has been blessing us. He's been blessing our church. He's been doing some wonderful things, and this is the last Sunday. And I want to prophesy. I want to speak to you. I want to minister to you and let you know that God is about to do something in your life this beautiful Sunday morning, the last Sunday in May. So the Bible says, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills from whence cometh my help. God is going to use this time we have together, just like the water that was poured into the vessels, that he turned into wine. He is using this 1 hour to change your destiny. to change your life and to touch your life. Let's pray for help from the Lord. Somebody, wherever you are, karandere mesha tarababa bandara. Help from above, oh God. Karandere mesete. Reke bene me kabra bababa. Rememe mesete bene me kabra bababa. Rasa tata bandere me kabra bakabarandere me. Mama andere me kebre sete me kendere me kabra babalabandos. Rike bere me masatara makabra baba. We lift up our eyes onto the hills, oh God. From whence cometh our help? Our help comes from you. A healing miracle comes from you. A breakthrough comes from you this morning, O God. Rakatabara bandere me kebres kebrendere. Katatabara babanda. Rakabara basatara bababara babara bandere. Rakabara basataya babanduru mo kebrendisa. Makata rama mama ndere me kebrende me sete merendisa. Rike promo sonduru mo kaya babaranda ramama. Rekete bere me kabara basatabara babandere. Help from the heavens, O God. Help from the heavens, O God. Karandere bere me ababa. Descend, O God, into our meeting this morning with power and with might. Marandere me kebrebe me. Like the woman with the issue of blood. Nobody could help her, but you, Jesus. We pray for your help this morning. The healing anointing, the healing power, the healing presence of God. We call upon it. We call upon you. We call upon the Spirit of God. I can feel the presence of the Lord even here in the studio. The presence of the Lord is here. Oh, Marandere me kabrasa tamara baba. Blessed be your holy name. Blessed be your holy name. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Father, this morning, I want to thank you for your love, your kindness towards us. I pray that this morning you will heal us and you heal our diseases. You will touch our lives and bless our fellowship and bless our lives. It is your desire to help us. Our help comes from you. I pray for help. Everyone who's watching and who's not feeling well and is sick this morning, help, oh God, from the heavens above. Thank you for miracles that are happening today. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Beautiful. 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 Wonderful. Wonderful. All right, there's a song that I want us to sing before I preach. I'm going to show it. It's here. Where are you, Lord? Where can I find you? You must be in this room, right by my side. I want to feel you. I want to believe. Experience your mighty presence with me. All of thy God in the midst of thee. He is a mighty God. He will save thee. You will rejoice over thee with joy. God in the midst of thee. He will rest. In his love, he will joy over thee with singing. Oh, 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 right by my side. Oh, such power, such a presence every. Where I go, but if you will not go with me,
oh yes, Lord,
I don't wanna go there. I don't wanna have anything where you are not involved. But oh Lord, I got in the midst of thee. He is a mighty God. He will save. Rejoice over thee with joy, God in the midst.
side.
Oh, the Lord is by your side this morning.
Heal with me.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Come and be close. Come and be close. Feel you like the wind blowing over my face. When I open my eyes, I want to see you there. But oh Lord, I got in the midst of thee. He's a mighty God. He will save thee. Will rejoice over thee with joy. God in the midst of thee. He will rest in his love.
Sing it one more time.
Right by my side.
The Lord is right by your side this morning.
Oh, such power, such a presence everywhere I go. But if you will not go with me, no, I don't want to go there.
Chapter 53 and verse 4. Isaiah chapter 53 and verse 4. Isaiah chapter 53 and verse 4. The Bible says that surely, I don't know whether you feel the presence of the Lord right where you are, surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smiting or smitten of God and afflicted. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God and afflicted. The Bible in basic English says that, but it was our pain he took, and our diseases were put on him. Don't you like that? It was our pain he took, and our diseases were put on him, while to us he seemed as one diseased, on whom God's punishment had come. Now, what is the source of diseases? How did we come here? How did we get here? How did we get to this place where there's so many diseases? Cancer, one of the deadly, you see, when the coronavirus was, you know, the pandemic, in those seasons, I mean, people were all afraid, you know, people were, you know, do all kinds of things, fear, washing hands. People wash their hands like they've never washed their hands ever before. You know, people, sanitizer became a very important commodity. It became more than gasoline. It became more precious than gold. Money was used. I mean, when it comes to sanitizer, you don't care about how much money you're paying. Even mask, until mask became $100 at border market. Mask was in the beginning of the pandemic, it was fantastic. But one of the things that you probably don't know is, I heard statistics even say that car accidents or something kills many more people in a year than the pandemic does for many countries. Oh yes. Oh yes. Cancer. Cancer is a very deadly disease. But you see, when the virus came and of course all the theories around it and all of that, it brought fear into many lives. But what is the source of all sickness? What is the source? Where did all of this come from? Now, it came from, and that's I want to answer that and give you one or two scriptures, and then we'll move into the prayer session. I know God is touching you already. I know God is healing you already. And as somebody who is sitting now watching me, your legs, your ankle bones, they were stiff. And I, in the realm of the spirit, I sense that they become loose. They become loose now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Glory be to God. And so sickness and diseases came from the Garden of Eden. Remember, God created man, Adam and Eve. God created Adam and Eve. He placed them in the Garden of Eden. And then he gave them an instruction about the fruit, the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. The Bible says that Adam and Eve, you know, they disobeyed God and they ate the fruit of the tree. Now, God is a fair God. God is a just God. How many know that God is a just God? God is not like your neighbor. God is not like your boss man. God is not like your supervisor. God is not like your fella, your child. God is not like your child father. God will send you money for your children. I'm telling you, God is not like your child father who's not paying the court. If you have taken him to court, but he's still not paying. God is not like your child father. I'm telling you, God is a good God. He's a just God. He's a righteous God. Now, when Adam and Eve, the creation of God, when they disobeyed God, as much as God didn't like it, in his being a just God, he had to discipline them. And if you're a just parent, if you're a just leader, parent, guardian, you discipline your children when they go off. And you got to be a demon for a child to be disciplined to set a place on fire. You got to be a demon. You got to be a demon for your phone to be taken away from you. And then it ends up killing 19 or 20, taken away. It got to be a demon. It got to be a demon. It got to be a demon. When we were growing up, there was no cell phone. You want a friend, you want to go and see your friend, you don't call. You walk all the way to your friend's house. And if the friend is there, that's fine. If the friend is not there, that's it. No, so for what we experienced in Madia, it was quite unfortunate. But that's what it is. The demons are all over. And there's something that's going on. And people are blind. You see, people are very, very blind. I passed through JFK the other day, and I'm sure it's even here. I heard it's over here. They're premiering the Little Mermaid movie. My God. When you get to JFK, John F. Kennedy Airport, You see this huge LED screens, and you see this Little Mermaid swimming in the water, and the promotion. When I saw it, I said, you know what? See, people are so blind. People are so blind. Now, I don't know if you heard it, but when the Passion of Christ was released, you know what happened in the theaters when it was shown? I don't know if you heard about it. Even the filming of the movie, the Passion of the Christ, the things that happened, there was a guy called Jim Caviezel, JC, Jesus Christ, the guy who acted as Jesus. He had a testimony on YouTube. You should go and look for it. I mean, the things he went through. He said lightning struck when he was on the cross. Real lightning struck multiple times. But the things that happened in the movie. And then when people went to the theaters to watch the movie, the healings that took place, the deliverance, the people cried, people gave their life to Christ. You see, that same effect is what the little mermaid is going to have on children and on people. Because the mermaid is it's not a fairy tale. There is a woman who is a mermaid who lives in the sea. And from that, right under the water, they are trying to promote mermaids. There's a popular place where people go and buy tea and things that has a symbol of a mermaid. I won't say it, you should know it. And it's big thing. I mean, people are saying, have you been there before? Have you gone there to drink tea? You go there and drink tea. You see that you burn 20 students. You know, most stupidness, man. And so, when Adam and Eve sinned, God said, you know what? I love you, Adam. Use me, son. I like the Creolese version of, the creation of the Jesus movie in Creolese. It's an audio. It's beautiful. It's nice. When you hear it, you laugh. You see how Jesus speaks Creolese. When you hear Jesus speak Creolese, you love Jesus for the rest of your life. And so God had to tell them to get out of there. Get out of the garden. He told them, get out. Adam, Eve, get out. Get out of here. He drove them out of the garden, away from the garden. Right? Now, they entered into a state called death. Because God told them that for the day that you eat of the fruit of this tree, you shall surely die. Now, it is the death that has caused all the things that we're seeing and experiencing. I'm talking about the source of sickness because, you see, he's the one who took our sick. That's what the scripture says. But it was our pain he took. And our diseases were put on him. That's what I'm talking about. I'm talking about the pain and the diseases that entered into the world because of sin. Because of sin. Because of sin. Today is 1 hour, isn't it? Today is an enjoy 1 hour enjoyment. I see Rudolph giving me a high five. No, Rudolph, we're not done yet. I've not even attended to pray for people who are sick this morning. I'm enjoying fully 1 hour. I'm totally blessed. I'm sure he's used to showing me 5 minutes more. So, when they died, when Adam and Eve died, that is where all corruption came from. Now, God created them not to die. But now we have to die. Eyes were supposed to see for the rest of your life. But because of the sin that Adam and Eve called upon themselves, now eyes can't see for the rest of your life. A time comes, you need to go and see and get some glass, some mirror. You go and cut some glass and put it on your eyes. So that you can see, so that you can be able to continue living. Now, diseases, cancer, diabetes, all kinds of things have entered into the world because of sin. It is, but Jesus came. You see, God still loves us, and so he sent Jesus Christ into this world to take away our pain, to take away our diseases, to take away our sin. Now, I want to show you some dimensions of divine healing. Medicine is influenced by God. Medicine is not man. God has to come in for somebody to put paracetamol together. It's God who actually created all the trees from which the extracts are taken and medicines are made. And so, as much as God drove us, Adam and Eve, out of the garden and sin, death, corruption. Now, you remember Methuselah, the guy who the oldest guy in the Bible, 969 years. Now, even at the age of 18, somebody is setting a place on fire and you are dying. At the age of 17, your life is cut short. Methuselah was an example, a little peek into how long we could have lived. Job said it, that a man who is born of a woman, his days are few and is full of trouble. The days that you and I, we have, by the grace of God, because of Jesus, my days are not full of trouble, but I have persecutions and challenges. They're all part of it. It's like what Adam and Eve did has caused a lot of corruption to be introduced into this world. That's why all the things we see are going on. But God loves us. And so he sent Jesus to come and bear our griefs and carry our sorrows. And so let me show you some dimensions of divine healing. Healing is real. There are things that doctors can't do. There are things that medicine can't do. There are things that nobody can do, but God can do it. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, divine healing, when God says he will touch you, he will heal you, he will take you from your condition, it is possible. Because even when Adam and Eve sinned, God sent Jesus to come and fix the problem through salvation. Through salvation. That is why Jesus is unique. I don't know who you believe in. You probably believe in a dog, believe in a cat, believe in a snake. But I believe in Jesus. Because the birth, the coming into this world, the correction of the corruption that was introduced to the world by Adam and Eve, by man, Jesus' introduction was prophesied all the way in the book of Genesis. From Genesis to Revelation, you see Jesus. You see Jesus. Jesus is littered in the scriptures. I don't know that monkey that you served. I don't know that snake you served. That cat you served. Whether the cat was prophesied, was spoken of by prophets in time past that they were going to come, that a time is going to come, you get a cat in Camberville that you serve. But I know about Jesus. He was part of the plan to help you. As somebody watching me, you have a heart problem, believe God with me. Today is your day for a miracle. Now we're going to put some numbers on the phone numbers as we go along. And when the Lord touches you, and the Lord is going to touch you, call us and share your testimony with us after the service, okay? Now, there are some dimensions of divine healing. And I want to introduce you to that before we pray. We're going to pray this morning. I tell you, the service started on a very wonderful note. I can feel the presence of the Lord. In fact, after here, I have to just go home and sleep. I've had church already. I don't know what my church members are going to do. I can't home and sleep. Now, the first thing I want you to understand is divine healing affects birth defects and genetic disorders. This morning, God is going to affect any defect that you came out of the womb with. Hallelujah. This morning, if there's any genetic disorder, because there are some things, some sicknesses, some diseases that are passed on from generation to generation. This morning, Jesus bore our griefs and carried our sorrows, and therefore you should not be sick in that condition anymore. Today is your day. This is the end of that disease. This is the end of that yoke. I prophesy and I declare over your life in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in John chapter 9 and verse 1, the Bible says, and as Jesus passed by, he saw a man which was blind from his birth. He saw a man who was blind since he was born. He's a man. He was a baby. And I'm sure he was giving a name from the first three letters from the father, the last three letters from the mother, and they put it together, and then Toisha or Tokaisha, something. I'm sure some fantastic name that was given to this one. He was born blind. This is something that the guy came out from the womb with. Now, if you look at these guys who are going around and say that they were born man and they are not man, they were born woman and they are not woman, some of them claim that they came with it from the womb. I'm not sure about that, but I know about this one here. It's written here. This one, I'm sure. Jesus, the scripture says so. All right? And as Jesus passed by, he saw a man which was blind from his birth. divine healing affects birth defects and genetic disorders. And his disciples ask him, saying, Master, who did sin? This man or his parents, that he was born blind? Can you see it here? So this guy was born blind. All right? Which means that this is a birth defect. Are you with me? Are you following me? It's a birth defect. Then the disciples ask, what was the problem? Who caused this? Is it genetic? Is it coming from the parents? Or is this man's own problem? So you see that this case that Jesus met here in John chapter 9 was both a birth defect and a genetic problem. Now Jesus said something. Jesus said something there in John chapter 9, if we want to just read a little bit of it. Jesus said that it's not this man, neither has this man sinned nor his parents, but that the works of God should be made manifest in him. Now, so Jesus was trying to say that, of course, this particular man is not his parents. But I'm sure you know. You see, I come from a family. I have an uncle. That my uncle can sell your house without you knowing. He will sell your house. You'll be there. People will come and say, they give you eviction notice. And you ask yourself, why? And so we bought the house. In your own house. I had an uncle like that. He's gone to the other side. Then I have a cousin. So my uncle, which is my mother, my mother's sisters, my mother's brothers, my uncle, one of them. I don't know before my uncle what was there, but I lived to hear and to see that my uncle, I mean, police station was this. It was like a hotel. Then, when it comes to us, that is my mother, my aunt, my mother's sister, my mother's brothers, all the children. There's also one among us, our generation. When people see him coming to their homes, they start locking their doors. His hand was very fast. He comes to your house today. When he leaves, it's like Sticky Bandit. You know Sticky Bandit? Something will get stuck to his hand by the time he's leaving. So you see that. And I'm sure there's something like, you know something like that. I'm sure there's something like that in your family. Where uncle has something. And then when you look down, then among the children, the nephews, the nieces, there's one of them that who has it. God can take it. Divine healing. That's what I'm talking about. Divine healing can take care of that situation. And that my cousin, he also has gone to the other side, where all of us are going to go. I don't know which turn he turned, which corner which he turned, but when you go over the bridge, there's a right and there's a left. I'm not sure whether he went to the right or he went to the left. I'm sure when I get there, there will be angels who tell me, Collins, this way. And so I'm rest assured, but I'm not sure about him. But I'm saying all of this to say that one of the effects or one of the things that divine healing can take care of is birth defects and genetic disorders. Now, you realize that this guy was healed. This man was healed. Jesus healed this guy. The Bible says that when he had thus spoken, verse 6 of John chapter 9, he spat on the ground and made clay of the spittle, and he anointed the eyes of the blind man with the clay. And said unto him, go wash in the pool of Siloam. He went his way therefore and washed and came seeing. Somebody who was born blind. It doesn't matter whether your situation you came out of the womb with. You see, sometimes I see some people, they're deformed and all of that, they were born like that. If you believe God with me this morning, if you're watching me from the West Bank, from the East Bank, from Georgetown, from Linden, from Esquibo, wherever you're watching me from, on Facebook, wherever, and you are suffering from a disease that you are born with, God wants to touch you. Jesus took that disease. He took it upon himself on the cross. You don't have to carry it any longer. Are you going to believe God with me this morning? It's your time for a miracle. The second thing that divine healing can do is divine healing affects emotional illnesses. Emotions. In our world today, one of the major areas we suffer from is emotional diseases, emotional areas, disappointments, broken hearts, dissatisfaction, discontentment. You work all the time. I mean, I remember when I entered into a full-time ministry when I came to the mission field. My boss fired me. Anytime I tell the story, I say it. I said, it was when I came to the mission field that I forgave my German boss. I tell you, I don't want to mention his name on air, but his name is ringing my head right now. I'll say it off air. My job was such a nice job. I loved my job, you know, managerial position in Europe. I mean, I thought I was, you know, in cloud nine or something like that. One day he came to the office and he said that he doesn't want me at the workplace anymore. And then just gave me a termination of contract document to sign. I took the paper and I went home. I couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe that out of the blue, somebody would want to get rid of me. I was hurt. Have you not been hurt in your life before? Ah, please, I beg you. Adu has been hurt in his life before. It is 70, 80 years. I'm sure Joshua probably has also been hurt before. There's little lives that people have. Hallelujah. But I want to tell you, in Luke chapter 4 and verse 18, the Bible says that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the hearts that are broken. To heal the hearts that are broken. Disappointments in this life. To preach deliverance to the captives and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised. And so this morning, for the few minutes we have, I want to pray for you. Especially situations that are from birth. From birth. You have a disorder. You have a sickness that is from birth. Believe God with me. Believe God with me. Something that's genetic. Your grandmother had it. Your mother had it. And you have it now. I'm telling you, Jesus came to break the yoke of that sickness over your life. You are suffering from an emotional breakdown this morning, wherever you are. He came to heal the brokenhearted. I am the Lord that healeth thee.
I am the Lord, your healer.
The Lord is your healer this morning. Wherever you are,
you sent your word.
Wherever you are. Wherever you are, I want you to just place your hand wherever you are. That's right. Wherever the sickness is, if it's a genetic disorder, I want you to place your hand on your heart. Healing from the presence of the Lord is coming your way. Wherever the disease is, wherever the sickness is, your heart is broken. You are disappointed. You know, a broken heart can cause you to become mental. I want you to lay your hand on your heart. And if you are sick in any part of your body, I want you to lay your hands. The power of God is coming. The power of God is coming to you right now. wherever you're seated, wherever you're watching from, in the name of Jesus, I rebuke that disease. I rebuke that problem. I rebuke that yoke. In the name of Jesus, it may be from birth. I take authority of that disease. I take authority of that situation. And I break the yoke of it in the name of Jesus. The power of God. I release the power of God. The power of God. I release it into your life, into your situation. Father, touch. Touch by your spirit. Touch by your spirit. Touch by your spirit. Heal and deliver, oh God. Heal and deliver. Kataya bandere me kabra baba seteria baba. Marabandere me kabra satara baba. I'm hearing cataract and glaucoma. I'm hearing cataract and glaucoma. Receive your healing wherever you are. Marandere me kebres ketebere. Makatabara mama mama. Makatala baba. It ends with you. It ends, that glaucoma ends with you. Today it ends today. Healing in your eyes. Healing in your eyes. Glaucoma and cataract. In the name of Jesus. Eye problems. Yes. The Lord is telling me that you were given glasses at a very tender age. At the age of 4 or 5. You were just given glasses just as you entered into this world. You couldn't even see better. The Lord is touching you. You've been wearing glasses from since the age of 4. The Holy Spirit is touching your eyes right now. Receive your healing in the name of Jesus. Receive your healing in the name of Jesus. Makaya basata rama kabrele mekeri. Rama mama sata barababa. Makatama nandara makabrele mekeri bele bebe. Retara makabra bababa. Mandere mekebre bele mekabara ya baba. Healing is taking place. Rakatara baba. Rakatara baba. Your cataract is no more. Your glaucoma is gone in the name of Jesus. Rakabara barababa. I tell you, you can see my 5 fingers right now. You can see me clearly. You can see my 5 fingers. Receive your healing. Receive your healing. Receive your healing. Receive your healing. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Somebody watching, you can't see well through your right eye. Your right eye. You can't see well through it. The Lord is touching those eyes. He's touching that right eye. That right eye is being worked on by the Spirit of God now. Healing in the name of Jesus. Somebody watching me, you were involved in an accident. You were involved in an accident and your right eye is gone. It's damaged. You actually can't see. It's blind. It's gone. You had a car accident. The Lord is healing your right eye. He's healing you. Receive your healing wherever you are. Karandere mekebrende. Makatabaranda ramakararandere mekebrende mekerie. Eyes are being healed. I don't know, there's something about eyes this morning. There's something about eyes. Call us. You know, there's a number. We're going to show you a number. Call us and let's testify. So we can read the testimonies to our viewers next Sunday. Karandere mekebrende. Makabarabandaraba. Marandere mekabrasataraba. Kerendere mekebrende mekarababa. Yes, Lord. Somebody suffering from appendicitis. Appendicitis. The Lord is touching you. He's healing you right now. Your appendix. In fact, you are scheduled for an operation. The Lord is healing you right now in the name of Jesus. He's healing you right now in the name of Jesus. He's healing you right now in the name of Jesus. Receive your healing. He bore our griefs. He took our sickness on the cross. The Bible says, by his stripes we were healed. By his stripes, you don't have to carry that sickness anymore. Marandere me cabra satara macabra baba. Mararandere me cabra satata barade. Your appendix is healed. The pain you've been suffering since last Friday. Macabra, since Friday, you've been experiencing pain. You are scheduled for an operation. The Lord is healing. He's healing. He's healing your appendix. In the name of Jesus, receive it. Receive it. It's real. It's real. It's real. Mande de me cabra da ma. Katata bara de me cabra satara baba. Rekeromo sotoromo cabra baba de de. Shatataya. Shashataya baba. Shashataya baraba cabra baba de de. Ratatamara macabrondo musete brebe brebe. Oh, blessed be your name. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Makaya bara de me cabra baba. Nakataya baba. There's a child mother. There's a woman who's watching. You've had two children with this gentleman. I don't know whether I should call him gentleman, but I'll call him gentleman. He is your gentleman. You still love him. You still love him. The disappointment as you've given birth to these two children has been too much. It has affected you. It has affected your performance at work. God is healing you. Yes, He's healing you. Lay your hand on your heart, wherever you are. Your child mother, your baby father, he was your first love. He was your first love. He was the first person you had an intimacy with. Out of that relationship, two children have come forth. He has broken your heart. You are disappointed at how things have turned out. God is touching. He's touching your heart. He's healing your heart. To heal the brokenhearted. To heal the brokenhearted. Karandere me kabra baba. Rakatata barandere me kiriya mama. Remololo soto mokora ndaya makandere me kibre bebe. I can see you crying. Don't cry. He's healing you. I can see you crying. He's healing your heart. He's healing your heart. He's healing your heart. He's taking out the pain. You're feeling a sharp pain. That's it. He's taking it away. Reborobo satabara babandere katatara mandere mekeri nedere bebe rakabara basata mana mana mandere mene mene remolo setebere kabra baba kabra baba yekete mene me kabra baba satara mama oh rara sitabara baba rama sotoro mekebre dere ya baba be healed be healed be healed be healed be healed in the name of Jesus makatabara baba. Thank you. Thank you. I want to pray for you. Migraine. 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 When that headache comes, you feel like hitting your head against a wall. God is touching and is healing you this morning. A migraine demon. Migraine curse, that genetic migraine, in the name of Jesus, be healed from it. Be healed from it. Lay your right hand on your forehead like this. Yes. Yes. The Spirit of the Lord is moving. He's moving. He's moving. He's moving. Your hand is getting hot now. The healing power of God is moving through your hand and it's taking away the migraine. In fact, you woke up this morning with it. You woke up this morning with it. You are tired of it. God is also tired of it for you. He's your healer and he's your helper. Receive your healing now in the name of Jesus. That genetic migraine be broken over your life in the precious name of Jesus. Makaya baraba sataya baraba kabra baba. Marandere me kibri debe. Yes, Lord. Sing it. Marandere me kibri debe. Yes, Lord. We thank you. Yes. We thank you for all the healings. We We thank you for all the miracles. We thank you for all the healings, the miracles, the deliverances, oh God. Yes, Lord. Bololo soto de bara baba 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 baba. Rasata tamarande de me makaya basete mende de me kebre me. Rebolo soto mukoria baba baba kabra baba baba. Thank you Lord Jesus. Thank you Lord Jesus. Thank you Lord Jesus. Karabande de re ya. Kaya bara baba baba baba. Marande de me kebende ya mama. Mandere me kabra sata barande de me kebre de re. Oh Jesus. Katatata. Glory be to your name, O God. 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 Rakatabara baba. Kabandere meke brendere. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name, O God. Father, I thank you for all the healings. Thank you for all the miracles. Thank you for your direction. Your direction. Thank you. Somebody's right ear is becoming clear. Your right ear. You couldn't hear from your right ear. The Lord is touching that ear. That ear is open now. You can hear. You can hear my voice clearly through your right ear. Just turn your right ear to the TV. You can hear me right now. Clearly. Receive your healing. Receive your healing now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. I want you to call that number. I want to show that number again. Call that number. If you were healed, I know you were healed. Or you have a testimony. Call those numbers. Call them now. Call them now. And share your testimony. Call those numbers now. Call those numbers now. I'm excited in my spirit. Call those numbers now. For that genetic, that disease that you are born with. Share that testimony with us. God has touched you and he has healed you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And now you're watching us. You're watching me. And you're not saved. You're not born again. If you die right now, you're not sure whether you go to heaven or hell. I want you to pray this prayer with me. You see, heaven is real. When you die, it will be like you cross a river. And when you cross a river, you need to know whether you're going on your right or you're going on your left. You know, most of the time when you travel, you get to an airport, you have to look for signs that apply to your situation at the airport. Sometimes you are just in transit, you have to look for the transit lane. Or sometimes you are just entering into the country, you have to look for that lane also. Now, what applies to you will apply to you when you die. If you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, I want you to pray this prayer with me. Say with me, Heavenly Father, I am a sinner. Forgive me of all my sins. Wash me with the blood of Jesus. I believe with my heart and I confess with my mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord. I believe Jesus died for me. I believe God raised Jesus from the dead. I open my heart and I receive Jesus to be my Lord and my personal Savior. I believe that by this simple prayer, I am saved. I'm born again. My name is in the book of life. I'm a child of God. Thank you, Father, for saving my soul. In Jesus' name, amen. At the end of this service, we'll give you an address. Come and see me. Come and fellowship with us, okay? Right at the Good Shepherd Church, at the west bank of the Demerara River, canal number 2, Pola. Okay, you'll see a short video clip right after the service. Now, I want you to give an offering. Give an offering. If you are blessed this morning, one full hour. If you are blessed this morning, you have our MMG number right there. You have our Scotia Bank right there. Send an offering. Give an offering. The Bible says in Acts chapter 20 and verse 35 that Jesus said there's more blessing in giving than in receiving. And so if you want to be blessed, you must be at the point where you give and not receive. Most people like to receive. The common thing is, that's how people are poor. Poor people always want to receive. And they are poor because they are always at the receiving end. But the Bible says it very differently, that it is the one who gives who stay out of poverty. And so give an offering. Give $5,000 Guyanese dollars. Give 10,000 Guyanese dollars. Give 100 US dollars. Give 50 US dollars. Wherever you are, MMG. If you don't have MMG, but the Lord has laid on your heart to give an offering, you don't have internet banking or something like that, call the number. Call the MMG number right there, 614-7909. Call that number and say, you know what? I have an offering. I want to give an offering to Not a Novice. Not a Novice. I want to give an offering. Wherever you are, we can make arrangements. Do not lose the opportunity to be blessed. There was a preacher who was believing God for an amount of money for a crusade. And I saw him put a testimony on Twitter. A lady walked from another state. This is in America. A lady came from one state to the other to meet him. He came with a check of $1 million. He was believing God. And I know somebody this morning, God has touched you to give an offering. Call that number and find us. Okay? For your blessing and for your reward. And so until I come your way again with Not a Novice, stay blessed. Walk in your healing, walk in your deliverance, and enjoy the mercy and the grace of God. God bless you.